hearts. So good evening, Professor Earl. Professor Earl?
Muted.
Evening to the Bernadette, to the Caradel. Right, left. Let's go some time and so Professor Earl will join. Professor Earl.
Yeah, sorry, Pastor Simon. Naghang ang computer ko. Siguro na-overwhelmed sa'yo. thank you for another time that we can meditate on God's Word and join our Bible study. Good morning, America, and good evening, Asia and Australia. We thank the Lord for His goodness and for sustaining us and for protecting us. Yesterday, we talked about instead of with Christ in my vessel, if I'm in Christ's vessel, we can smile at the storm. Because I think it is just logical that when we are going astray, when we have our own when we are pursuing our own selfish dreams in this world, you don't expect that you will have the blessing of the Lord, and that is granted if that you are the child of God. Although that God promised that He will really work out someday that you will really become like the Lord Jesus Christ. So that is why it would be a big struggle. Because the Lord will really force you by His grace. He will really insist that we should obey. So if a person thinks that he's a Christian and yet he's not obeying God, he doesn't even enjoy reading God's word, the fellowship, probably there's something wrong. And that is why we need to constantly check whether we are of the faith. Remember, Matthew, the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 7. We said yesterday that the Lord Jesus Christ, as presented by Matthew, he was no ordinary person. Kasi instead of just praying to the Father, Lord, Father, I know that you are powerful. Please stop the rain, stop the storm, stop the wave. Hindi, pinagalitan niya. And then suddenly, there was calmness. No? Nawala yung... And that is why I hope that by God's grace, we should join God in His mission. Because that's His will. That's His will, that all of us are joining Him in gathering His worshipers from every tribe, towns, and nations. And for sure, the Lord placed you on that job, particular job. The Lord had placed you there in America or in Australia or in Singapore or in Cambodia because He has a purpose. You're supposed to be there to be a testimony of the Lord Jesus Christ, to let our light shine before men, that they may see our good works and glorify our Father who is in heaven. Sana hindi pareho tayo kay Lot. If you remember our study in Genesis, in Lot chapter 19, in Genesis chapter 19, na si Lot, instead of leading his family and the community to the Lord Jesus Christ, parang iba yung pinagkakabalahan niya. And I hope after yesterday, we will have that resolve to beg the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, it is our prayer that starting now, may we be found faithful in your work, giving you the glory that you really deserve. Now, this time, Iba naman. Iba naman. Siguro kung if there's one thing na a lot of people are scared of, and sometimes, or many times, mga Christians din, we're afraid of the spirits, yung mga demons. And that is why there are places na pinupuntahan tayo na parang ayaw mong pumasok kasi takot ka sa multo or takot ka sa mga spirits that are there. And hindi lang takot, sometimes hindi ka makatulog because may mga naririnig ka. And for me, if you will just listen to what we will study this evening, and just have faith in this, kahit saan pa siguro ang katakutan natin dapat yung tao, hindi yung mga espiritu. And I'll elaborate more. Yesterday, I mentioned that in one of the seminars that I attended, that one reason why the disciples got scared because they believe in the power of darkness na nasa tubig. And that is why they said that, oh, we're scared because probably the evil power is overwhelming us. But the Lord Jesus Christ stood and just ordered the storms and the waves to come, the way the storms to go away and the waves to stop, and that's it. So we will now go to our study. And this is our topic this evening. Actually, this is a very common passage, but I hope because the word of the Lord is quick and powerful, sharper than any two-edged sword, the word of the Lord is alive. I hope we could look at this with freshness and would be encouraged. Dahil ang salita ng Diyos will always strengthen us and would give us a refreshing spirit every time we open and study His Word. Now, according to the Bible here, and when He came to the other side, to the country of Gadarenes, so this is a Gentile place on the other side of Galilee. Ang nag-welcome sa kanila, two demon-possessed men. So imagine kung like, pagdating mo sa isang place and you're new for sure sa mga disciples si Jesus Christ. Probably that's the first time because as Jewish believers, they won't even as Jewish believers, they won't even dare to go to a Gentile territory in the same way that they tried to avoid the yung tawag dito, yung mga yung territory ng mga Samaritans sa John chapter 4, as we if you remember our study in the book of John. So nung dumating sila doon, demon possessed man, according to the Bible here, coming out from the tombs. So imagine ang mag-welcome sa iyo, someone is being possessed, and then he came from the tomb. So parang for sure nakakatakot, as far as probably the disciples are concerned. And not only that, hindi lang yung demon possessed, he came from the tombs, they were so fierce that no one could pass that way. So hindi sila makapasok. Why? Because these persons were there, probably to run after anyone who would dare to pass that area. And in parallel passages, maybe we should if you have time, I'll just check that these demon possessed persons, even na nakagapos sila, they could still afford. I mean, they're so powerful. They can free themselves. That's how powerful it is. Although sa ibang passage ang minention lang one person, dito dalawa. It's not that there's a parang inconsistency, but I think the focus there is on that one person who tried to follow Jesus Christ after, and which Jesus Christ said, don't come with us. You go and tell what great things the Lord has done for you. So I think that's that's the explanation. So I believe that there were hesitations on the part of the disciples of the Lord Jesus Christ when they saw this parang nakakatakot, this two persons who were living in the tombs possessed by demons. Pero sa surprise, they were surprised probably because when they saw Jesus, behold, they cried out. They said, "What have you to do with us, O Son of God?" Ala, nandito ka? Anong gagawin mo sa amin? And then they said, "Have you come here to torment us before the time?" So they said, "Are you going to punish us now? Are you going to punish us kasi you're gonna send us siguro sa hell, which alam na nila na yun ang pupuntahan nila. So kung ano sila kabagsik sa mga beginning portions of what we studied this evening, ganun din sila natakot kay Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ, wala pa rin sinasabi sa kanila. According to verse 30, "Now, a herd of many pigs was feeding at some distance from them." Yung livelihood ng mga tao, ng mga Gentiles doon, they're raising pigs. So of course, para sa mga disciples, uneasy sila because para sa kanila itong mga pigs are unclean animals. So the demons beg him, saying, "If you cast us out, send us away into the herds of pigs." Sa ibang passage, tinanong sila ni Jesus, "Anong pangalan mo?" Sinabi nila na, anya na, "My name is Legion because we are many." Ang Legion would mean 1,000. So imagine ang tao na may 1,000 demons inside him. Kahit nga yung isang tao na unbeliever, di ba? Parang yung ugali, mapagkamalan mo, how much more pa kung there's 1,000 demons inside that person. You see how controlled the demons, that person, the two persons by demons. So dalawa sila, and that is why may mga 2,000 spirit, lahat-lahat. So ito yung mga demons, they beg. So if you notice here na nung nakita nila si Jesus, they got scared. They were asking ug time na nila to be tortured, and then they were begging the Lord Jesus Christ. Katakot. That's how scared they are. That's how they tremble before the Lord Jesus Christ. And they said, if you cast us out, send us away into the herds of pig. So they begged the Lord Jesus Christ, na, kung pwede, if you're going to throw us out, please allow us na kung pwede, you could send us sa mga baboy. And then si Jesus, I don't know, you might have wondered, and he said to them, go. So they came out and went into the pigs, and behold, the whole herd rushed down to the steep of the bank into the sea and drowned in the water. So sinabi ng other passages na there were like 2,000 pigs. So ilang lechon yun? Grabe. So you can only imagine yung pagkatakot pa ng mga tao, ng mga those na nagbabantay, to see all their pigs running and jumping into that steep and got drowned into the waters. So ang ginawa ng mga tagabantay, those who are taking care of the pigs, they fled, and going into the city, they told everything, especially what had happened to the demon possessed. So nung umuwi sila sa city, doon sinabi nila. At yung focus ng kanilang mga discussion, what had happened to those two demon possessed men. Kasi for sure, most of the people who've been to that place knew about these two men, how uncontrollable they were. And for sure, they saw everything that had happened. Sinabi nila na suddenly there was a group of people who came there, and yeah, bigla na lang nag-behave, and ang problema lang yung ating mga baboy jump because the evil spirit transferred to this. According to kasi wala tayong time to check the other, you could check some Mark chapter 5, by the way. And behold, at the city came out to all the city came out to meet Jesus. And according to Mark chapter 5, na they saw this person na matino na siya, behaved na normal na, unlike before. Pero very sad dito, because according to verse 34, behold, all the city came to meet Jesus, but unlike the Samaritan people, remember yung Samaritan woman, after believing that Jesus Christ is the Messiah, tumakbo siya, and she told the whole community na na may isang tao dito who knew all the things about me, is maybe this is the Messiah. So also the whole city went there. But they went there because they believe sa sinabi ng Samaritan woman, and they wanted Jesus to tell them more. So Jesus stayed 2 days longer, and the whole community believed. They said, it is no longer because of what you told us, referring to the woman, but we have already seen and heard that he is the Savior of the world. Very big. Iba. Ang ginawa nila, sinabi nila, Jesus, please, you go. You're not welcome here. Please, leave us alone. Leave us alone. So, this is very strange. Because they saw, nakita nila dapat yung power ni Jesus Christ over demons, yung power ni Jesus Christ yung over the yung tao na naibalik niya sa tamang katinuan. So you might ask, bakit pinalis nila si Jesus? Bakit pinalis nila si Jesus? For me, and that is also the opinion of many, they wanted Jesus to live. Why? Because of money. Natakot sila na if Jesus Christ would continue to stay there, baka maubos yung baboy nila. At malan sila ng kanilang kabuhayan. So that is really, really sad. It's really, really sad. That the people, instead of, sandali, who are you? Why are you that powerful? Please tell us. But since at stake ang kanilang kabuhayan, they don't want Jesus Christ to stay a little bit longer. And I think that kind of perspective, that kind of attitude is still present these days. Ng mga tao would rather not believe in the Lord Jesus Christ kasi they are doing some things na para sa kanila would compromise their economic well-being. Baka if I'm going to become a Christian, mawala na ko ng inheritance. If I'm going to believe in Jesus Christ, baka mawala na ako ng trabaho, baka, you know, the Lord will not like what I'm doing, so I'd rather not believe. And I don't know if how many of us, sana wala lang, sana wala, na even though there are moments na because of our faith, because of our faith, because of our conviction, medyo natifetan yung ating economic well-being. I hope you will continue to just hold on, knowing that if we're going to see righteousness, all the things, all our needs will be added to us. Now, I think ang isang question, Lord, bakit pinayagan mo yung mga baboy na mapasukan ng mga evil spirit? Yes, kawawa naman yung may mga mayari, di ba? Sayang naman ganoon. But I believe Jesus Christ had a purpose in doing this. In a way, maybe that this is judgment to the community because of their hardening. Jesus Christ knew that these people are so particular with their wealth. I think Jesus Christ allowed that to happen primarily to reveal the real hearts of the people of the community. They have no time for the Messiah. They have no time for the Lord Jesus Christ. They will only believe probably in the Lord Jesus Christ kung di affected ang kanilang kabuhayan. And that is why, if you remember our study regarding the two persons, the scribe and that one disciple who wanted to follow Jesus, we said that when we follow the Lord Jesus Christ, it costs. And many times the Lord Jesus Christ has to, there are moments that the Lord Jesus Christ has to provide trial to people so that that trial will make him closer or will make him go to stay closer to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. God used difficult moments in our lives to bring us to him. And sana should be the attitude of the people. Wow, you are so powerful. Who are you? Please tell us and please help us because wala na kami kabuhayan because of the pigs. Please tell us what to do. Why are you so strong that these things happen? Sa kanila, wala na. Pero if there's another thing, na why the Lord Jesus Christ allowed the evil spirit to get into the body of those pigs is as a testimony sa mga disciples of Jesus Christ. Kasi if the Lord just cast the demons, the disciples hindi nila makita yung mga demons kasi the demons are spirits. Pero kung pinapasok sila sa katawan ng mga baboy, if the Lord allowed, the disciples could see how scared before their eyes, they could see how scared the demons in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. Parang makikita mo na, di ba parang makita mo yung taong tumatakbo dahil sa takot. Dahil takot sila. And you could see, and they would rather jump into the cliff and die than stand before the presence of the Son of God. Kung ako yun, mabawaw to some demons. Walang nagawa. Napaka ginawa si Jesus. Presence pa lang ni Jesus. Pero takot. Brothers and sisters in the Lord, into 1 John chapter 4, sinabi ni Apostle John, little children, you are from God and have overcome them, for he who is in you is greater than he who is in the world. We must always remind ourselves that the God that is in us is way, way, way greater than he that is in the world. According to Colossians chapter 2, verse 15, sinabi ng Bible, he disarmed the rulers and authorities and put them to open shame by triumphing over them in him. Actually, Jesus Christ was talking about his victory when he died on the cross. After dying on the cross, he actually disarmed our seven authorities, and they were put to shame. Because when Jesus Christ was suffering, for sure the enemy was also busy working in the hearts of the enemies of Jesus Christ so that Jesus Christ will die. But at the end of the day, napahiya sila. Because Jesus Christ won over sin and death. So, in closing, the Apostle Paul reminded the people, the disciples, the followers of the Lord Jesus Christ in the church of Ephesus, by saying, finally, be strong in the Lord and in the strength of his might. We must be strong. Let us put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the scheme of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic power of this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in heavenly places. Yeah, we are wrestling against the spiritual world, but they are no match to the power and even just the presence ng ating Panginoon. So if God is for us, who can be against us? Amen. Let us pray. Father God, thank you for this comfort that the enemy, even the governing spirit in this world, are no match to the power, even just the presence ng aming Panginoon. And we are grateful, Father, because you are in us. And no one can pluck us out in your hand. So, Father, just comfort us every time that we may fear that the powers of the enemy would try to scare us. Please allow us hope in this portion of the scripture and tell the enemies, Jesus Christ is in me. And I know you're scared. And my God will never leave me. He will never forsake me. Lord, please give us that confidence. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thank you.
Sir, I give the time to any questions or any thoughts. Anybody like to share? That's the wall.
Yes, Brad. You don't need to have a third eye to know that there are spirits, because there are spirits, diba? He just tempted us, diba? While listening to me, diba? There's something na nagtitempt sa iyo. So, no need. They're everywhere. They're here. They will not stop because the enemy will always try to paralyze so that we will be useless in the kingdom of heaven. Regarding the future, hindi lang ako sure. Kasi kung if you know the future, mas paganda, yayaman ka dito. They said if you just know what will happen five minutes before, you know what will happen, just yung 5 minutes before that thing would happen, kung alam mo lang, you will control the whole world in a short time. Mayaman ka, you would know the stock market, you know a lot. So that is why I don't know them personally, but I think if there's one thing that we should know about the future is that God is already there and all the things that He had promised already in the Bible. Kasi, you know, mas nakakatakot kung you know the Bible, you know the future. You know why? Imagine kung alam mo na 3 days from now, mamamatay ka. It's like 5 seconds more, 4, 3, 2. Nakakatakot, di ba? Parang wala ka. And that is why it is the Lord has been telling us that the just shall live by faith. Because it's not only that faith glorifies God, but it also would help us cope with the challenges here. With the challenges here sa mundo. Yung faith. Yun lang siguro, brother. Torture area, yeah, be there. Yeah, amen. Actually, ang totoo niyan, if we just keep on entertaining, would really be intimidated. Especially the enemy knows where kung ano yung mga areas that we are vulnerable. So kung may mga tao na who are easily intimidated through that, they would really find means. In the same way na there are areas in our lives that we are vulnerable, mga temptations. So yun ibibigay ng enemy. Yeah, there's kung pupunta ka doon because of what had happened. I mean, parang you can't help but imagine the sufferings of the people there. Yeah, so it's very sad, and parang yeah, yung feeling it's quite parang not good But sa akin yun, just pray that the Lord would save the Cambodians na sana they will come to know the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Yeah. Pero ang importante lang doon, hindi rin tayo take heed because there might be possibility that we will also fall. So we must constantly depend on the Lord Jesus Christ. If you remember in one of our Bible studies, that isang reason din that the Lord allows us to see phenomena of demon possession is to prove rin na may Panginoon, di ba? So pag may evil spirit, di ba dapat may good spirit? At hindi yan ma-explain ng evolution. Why is it that there are evil spirit? So we should in a way be grateful na may mga phenomena na ganun, because that only proves that God is true, that the Bible is true. And we should really take that seriously and repent of our sins and believe in the Lord Jesus Christ so that we will not perish but have eternal life, rather than be with these fallen angels because of their rebellious heart against God. Sige. Yeah, he can, and maybe not. Siguro yung mga subconscious lang natin. But I think hindi naman yung devil cannot get into us, because we have the Holy Spirit in us. He has no place. So hanggang labas lang siya. And takot lang siya pumasok kasi we have the Holy Spirit there. So, off-limit sila. I mean, in fact, ang isang issue pa doon, that before he would touch us or he would try to tempt us, may mag-ask pa siya ng permission sa Panginoon. So, he cannot just do things as they wanted us to do. Kasi ang mga evil spirits, they have power to hurt us. They have power to, remember Job? They could provide scenario na to really inflict pain and even death. Pero yung Panginoon has the final say. Ang interesting doon is that yung intention of the devil is to make us bad. Pero God is so wise that he will always, even the intention of the enemy to hurt us or to do something to tempt us, God will eventually use that for our own good. And we will always win. So that's how great our God is, and that's how loser the enemy is. Amen. Meron pa ba?
Pastor, good morning. Good evening.
Good morning, Sister Mary Grace.
Oh, it's just very, it's a reminder, no? That this is really very true, that we are really fighting while we're here on earth, that there's really that kind of spirit, the bad spirit and the good spirit. And when we remind ourselves where we belong all the time, you know, it's not that we belong to God already and we don't do anything. We still have to really every day make ourselves fortify talaga our hearts pa, that He is with us. Because for me, Pastor, I really believe in those spirits, no? It's not that the belief that I have is for me to really know that they are around so that I can cling to God more. Sometimes there were moments in my life, especially when you talk to, there was once when I was speaking to my pamangkin, I don't know, I was really calling heavens because I felt like he was arguing with me and the bad spirits were really around me. I was just letting him talk, you know, when you counsel someone like that, and he is one disturbed kid, you know, unfortunately, we have a lot of that in the family, natin, lalo na mga bata. But at that very moment, I really felt that there was this very, very bad spirit in between that I was really calling on the Lord. The more you seek God, the more that aragid ang mga amo na bala nga spirit, no? But, grabe gid ang resistance. So, ambal ko, Lord, just be with us. So, I really, truly feel na aragid na. But our God is more powerful than anything else, and that's His promise. That's written in the book of His life, and He is life. And so, even though there's always a reason for us to fear, but His love remains. No? Just the other day lang, I was attending one Bible study. I don't know, Pastor, for whatever reason, kabaluman ko sa mga books sa Bible, but that 1 minute, 2 minutes in a span of time, I couldn't find the book. You know, when you want to seek God, if you are truly wanting to know about Him, there is that spirit all the time that just tries to bother you. And I said, Lord, what's going on? That was like, I just felt it just this week. Humble ko nga man mo tuman, but then, of course, the devil will not win over our desire to know more about God. But it is true. It's happening. I just wanted to share from what I've felt. Thank you.
Thank you, sister. Thank you. Yeah.
Pastor?
Yeah, okay. Go ahead, no?
Is it possible that a Christian be possessed by the evil spirit?
For me, my position is hindi na for me, hindi. Because the Holy Spirit nandun na. And for me the best way to help you na who have experiences having devil possession is for them to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior. Kasi sa akin, why they could possess you? Because yung Holy Spirit is there, di ba?
Okay, yeah. Okay, I got you. Thank you, Pastor.
Do you have any thoughts or questions?
Pastor, excuse me. Good evening.
Hey, good evening, ma'am. Yeah.
Pastor, just want to ask, like, about the devil or the demon possession. Kagina, napaminsan ko, Pastor, maybe the devil will feed our fear, like, kung anong concepts ang tao about the devil, or like, for example, aswang. So actually may mga testimonies, Pastor, nga the real experience na sa ilang vision yung nakita nila ini, or kung dito sa Pilipinas, let's say gingbagat sila or nakita sila manalanggal, but in the other place of the world lain man ang ilang ano concepts on horror or something like as long as hindi man nila ma-appreciate, di man makilala sa mga taga northern or something, and like Dracula or vampire here in the Philippines, maybe siguro kay tungod sa America nga pag dala diri, so na-appreciate na or na-convey na nila. Pero I mean, maybe the devil pastor will feed our fear through that ideas.
Yeah, that is, I think, Ma'am Bernadette, that is true. Kung ano ang what you are believing, you would really see it. Ang lola ko is actually a ano yun, parang doctor sa community, na parang nagluluya, yung ganun.
Asorano, something like that, pastor.
Sorana, something. And that's my lola. One time I saw her he trying to heal a lady na who had a I think a lump sa breast niya. So yun ang ginawa niya, parang kumuha siya ng parang gabi, ano yun sa English, yung, and then she cleaned it and placed yung parang clean water and drop it and place it in on top of the breast of the lady, and she did some ceremonies. And then after that, she opened it, may mga shells inside. Oh, may mga shells, you could really see it. And that's what she's famous for sa community. So if you will really try to believe and entertain, that the devil can always provide and even strengthen your belief. If you remember sa Matthew chapter 7, na diba yung sinabi na not everyone who calls me Lord, Lord will be able to enter heaven. At isa sa ginagawa nila, they did miracles. And I believe the miracles that they did is not in the power of God, but in the power of the enemy. In the same way, alam natin when we study, if you study the book of Revelation, diba, may mga kakampi ang enemy who will perform actually many miracles. And that is why a lot of people in this world would believe and even worship him. So it doesn't mean that people perform miracles or did this, that. They're already in the right. The only authority about the will of God is the Bible. It's the Bible. It's not how we see what's going on in the lives of other people, even though if they can do a lot of magics and seemingly miracles, because that is not the way the Lord Jesus Christ had instructed us, or God had instructed us, to know who God is and to determine his will. We must go to the book. Always go to the book.
Thank you, Pastor. Another thing, Pastor, maybe I'm not yet a parent, but sometimes as I experienced when I was young, that maybe my mother or my grandmother told me if I will not listen or I disobey, they told me, ha, bahala ka, may aswang, or whatever. So during the years of that child, of their younger years, the start na nila visualize what is aswang. So as a parent, maybe someday, maybe must be careful sa pagpahog ba, like, may amuna. Because sa baby magdako sila, may mga possibilities na ma-visualize na nila or ma-imagine na nila. So maybe it's not good.
Yeah, no. I think if we are going to deal with our children, especially sa kanilang kasalanan regarding their sin, tell them that that is not good, because that is against God. God, the Lord Jesus Christ, you are insulting God, or you are parang giving that a good testimony sa Panginoon. In fact, on my part, as I deal with my daughter, never akong nagsabi na wag kang ganun, or don't do that because your father is a pastor, or nakakahiya kasi tatay mo pastor. I always tell her na nakakahiya because we are insulting God, no? Pabayaan mo lang tatay mo, nakakahiya yan. but we should not commit to those things because we don't want God to be sad or to be insulted by what we do. So I think it's always reminding people that whenever they do things, they are doing it against God, and that's not good. It's not good. Thank you, sister. Meron pa ba?
Pastor, pwede mag-ask question?
Sure.
Kasi may nagpa-ask na, how do you know, Pastor, na if a person is possessed by a evil spirit, and how will you cast it? How will you cast them, or how you cast the evil spirit within you, or yung na-possess na tao? And is it right, Pastor, if yung kunyari ma-anxious ka or ma-depressed ka, is it right to say na may spirit ka of depression or something like that, Pastor? And yun nga, yung how do you know na may evil spirit within you or ganun, Pastor? Or may evil spirit sa ganun na tao? And how will you, like, i-cast yun na spirit?
I don't know, pero sa, I'm not sure sa Bible kung may mga spirit of depression or spirit of whatever. We must, ang isang clear lang doon, that the devil is like a roaring lion seeking whom to devour. Meaning to say, the enemy will use all the means possible to destroy us. Ang term ni Jesus Christ kay Peter is, the enemy had asked permission to sift you like wheat. But according to the Lord Jesus Christ, but I have prayed for you. So maybe you would just say the evil spirit in general, because the enemy will use all means to discourage us, to look at circumstances negatively, and then of course na as much as possible to keep us from trusting the Lord. So many people would say that that's the spirit of ganito. Pero ang bottom line lang dyan is ang issue ng spiritual maturity. So we really struggle because we need to really grow in the knowledge, grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Wala pa akong experience regarding casting ng demons. I believe that the best way is to proclaim the gospel. Is to proclaim the gospel, to
amen,
to preach the gospel. Because the enemy might try to resist, but the only way to liberate us from the power of darkness is the gospel. It's the gospel. So I think yun lang siguro, yun lang. Kasi kung i-cast lang ang kwan, yung demon, paalisin, as we will study later, babalik rin yan. Babalik rin. In fact, according sa Bible, there was a story na lumabas siya sa isang tao, and then he came back, nag-invite pa siya ng mas madami. So always go to the gospel, because the power of God to salvation for everyone unbelieves. Eh kung makast mo, tapos hindi mo naman i-share ng gospel, ganun pa rin yun. The kingdom of darkness pa rin yun. Please say, brother. Yeah, tama. I think based sa sinabi mo, Brother Al, at reminded din ako sa comment kanina ni Sister Bernadette, that the enemy usually do that demon possession kung ang area yung mahilig pa yung mga tao sa superstition, yung parang they still believe in spirits, you know. Doon yung mga areas na very common ang demon possession. Pero sa mga areas like urban areas seldom yon kasi materialism naman, last materialism yun yung patok, di ba? So there you could see that the enemy is always looking for the best tool to distract us from growing in loving God above all.
Thank you, Pastor. Thank you, Brother Thank you. Al. And last, Pastor, what's your comment about other beliefs that don't eat pork? Because sa lesson natin yung, di ba, yung evil spirit nagpunta sa pig. So, maybe, I don't know, Pastor, some of the other groups na they don't eat pork. So, anong makomment mo dun, Pastor?
Anong group? Yung keto?
I think for me, hindi naman yung what the Lord Jesus Christ said in Matthew chapter 15 na hindi yung pumapasok sa ating katawan ang that would make us unclean. Actually, yung lumalabas. And when we look at Acts chapter 15, I think I mentioned this not only regarding Sabbath, but sa Acts chapter 15, sinabi doon na you can do anything. Yung regarding ang question doon, kung ang mga Gentiles have to observe the ang tawag dito, yung have to observe the culture of the Jews, the tradition, like circumcision, like yung ginagawa nila in order to become Christians. So Apostle Paul, sinabi niya hindi. So they went to Jerusalem at they went sa kay Pastor James, nandun rin si Peter. And then si James said na let us not burden the Gentiles. Kasi sinabi ni Peter na why we should insist na yung mga Gentiles should do the things na our father. So na tayo mismo hindi natin masunod why force them. So James said na hindi lang ang hinihingi lang namin na don't don't eat na yung offer to idols, yung mga may dugo pa, at saka yung yung commit fornication, no? Or adult adultery, and that is for the sake of fellowship, no? sa mga Jewish people. So wala doon na sinasabi na ganitong mga food, ganitong food, ganitong food, ganitong food. It was not mentioned there. And in fact, the Lord Jesus Christ, when he dealt with the non-Gentile group, sa mga Gentiles, sa ministry niya, he healed them and he honored them with their faith. Tapos hindi niya sinabi, oh, by the way, huwag kayong magkumain ng baboy or ganito. Jesus didn't say that. He just introduced himself as the Messiah, that the people would believe in him. So that after the Lord Jesus Christ died on the cross, they believe, a lot of them believe, especially sa Gadara area. Yun isa sa mga areas where yung Christianity really flourished after the death and resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. So, si Jesus Christ, hindi siya that conversant about food. He is always conversant on yung heart, yung purity ng heart, rather than what goes inside and or ceremonies na ginagawa ng mga religious leaders. So I think yun lang siguro.
Thank you, Pastor.
Yeah.
Pastor, another question.
Sige, sis.
I have my friend here listening, and she wants me to ask you. She told me if it is possible, if you are literally you are, it is possible na ma-possess ka daw, something like that, Pastor.
Sa akin kasi, kung you have the Lord Jesus Christ in your life, you have the Holy Spirit there. So I don't think na mapo-possess ka pa, because we're supposed to be controlled by the Holy Spirit. So I doubt. Although there were some cases before na Christian daw, ganito, pero hindi ako maka-comment. Pero kung you're going to check the scripture, dapat ang enemy hanggang sa labas lang natin. They cannot get in.
Thank you though, Pastor.
Yeah.
Okay. So any more questions? Our last call. All right, if not, thank you, Pastor Errol. Thank you for your teaching today. You have a good night, and I'm going to ask you to all if you can close us in prayer.
Amen. All right, good evening, good morning.
Amen.
Good evening, amen. Pastor Errol.
Thank you, Pastor Errol.
Thank you, Pastor Errol. Thank you, everyone.
Good morning. Good morning.